it.delhi.gov.in it.delhi.govt.nic.in Delhi Government Centralized Circular Order Important Scheme it.delhi.govt.nic.in Delhi Government Centralized Circular Order Important Schemes Circular Orders Important Schemes E-Gazette Circulars Orders Important Schemes E-Gazettes EGAZAT Date Department Subject Com Date Department Transport Draft Notification on Color Scheme of Buses and Transport Vehicles Administrative Reform Ambedkar Institute of Technology, Art, Culture and Language Audit Central Jail Chacha Nehru Bal Chikitsale Chit Fund College of Arts Conservator of Forest Delhi Commission for Women Delhi Electricity Regulatory Commission Delhi Financial Corporation DFC Delhi Financial Corporation DFC Delhi Fire Services Delhi Jal Board DJB Delhi Kalyan Samiti Delhi Khadi Village Industries Board DKVIB Delhi Labor Welfare Board Delhi Legislative Assembly Delhi Minority Commission Delhi Pharmacy Council Delhi Pollution Control Committee Delhi State Civil Supplies Corporation Limited DSCSC Delhi State Civil Supplies Corporation Limited DSCSC Delhi State Election Commission Delhi State Industrial and Infrastructure Development Corporation Delhi Subordinate Services Selection DSSB Board Delhi Subordinate Services Selection Board DSSB Delhi Transco Limited Delhi Transport Corporation DTC Department of Delhi Disaster Management Authority, Department of Food Safety, Department of Urban Development, Department of Women and Child Development, Deputy Commissioner Central, Deputy Commissioner East, Deputy Commissioner New Delhi, Deputy Commissioner Northeast, Deputy Commissioner Northwest, Deputy Commissioner North, Deputy Commissioner Southwest, Deputy Commissioner South, Deputy Commissioner West, Development, Directorate of Agricultural Marketing, Directorate of Economics and Statistics, Directorate of Economics and Statistics, Directorate of Health Services, DHS, Directorate of Small Savings, District Session Judge Office, District Administrative Revenue, Education Chief, Electoral Office, Election Chief Electoral Office, Environment, Exercise, Finance, Food and Supplies, GAD, Govind Ballabh Pant Hospital, GTB Hospital, Higher Education, Hindi Academy, Home Guard and Civil Defense, Homeopathy Wing, IHBAS, IHBAS, Industries, Information and Publicity, Information Technology, Irrigation and Food Control, INFC, Labor, Land and Building, Law and Justice and Legislative Affairs, LN Hospital, Loknayak, Lokayukta, LN Hospital, Lokayukta, NCC, OBC Commission, Office of Financial Commissioner, Planning Principal Account Office, Public Grievance Commission, Public Work Department, PWD, Registrar, Cooperative Society Services, Social Welfare, Rehabilitation Services, Trade and Taxes, Training and Technical Education, Transport, Union Territory Civil Services, UTCS, Union Territory Civil Services, UTCS, Vigilance, Weight and Measures, Welfare of SCST. Department of Women and Child Development, Dori Prohibition Officer, to be published in Part 4 of Delhi Gazette, Extraordinary Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, Department of Women and Child Development, Women Empowerment Cell, Pant Ravi Shankar Shukla Lane, KG Marg, New Delhi 1, Notification, 18 October 18, Notification. F, in exercise, in exercise of the powers conferred by subsection 1, 8B of DORI, प्रोहिबिशन एक्ट 1961, 28 ऑफ 1961, रीड विद गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स नोटिफिकेशन नंबर SO 1560 डेटेड 29 जून 1961 एंड ऑफ सुपर सेशन ऑफ नोटिफिकेशन नंबर्स डेटेड 3 सितंबर 1998 एंड F 59 डेटेड 4 जनवरी 2001 एक्सेप्ट एज रिस्पेक्ट्स थिंग्स डन और ओमिटेड टू बी डन बिफोर सच सुपरसेशन द लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर इज हियर बाय प्लीज टू डेजिग्नेट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली एज डोरी प्रोहिबिशन ऑफिसर्स फॉर इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द प्रोविजन ऑफ द सेड एक्ट इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ एरियाज ऑफ नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली एज स्पेसिफाइड बिलो नेमली सीरियल नंबर डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ ऑफिसर्स एरिया ऑफ जुरिस्डिक्शन डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर ईस्ट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर नॉर्थ ईस्ट डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर न्यू दिल्ली द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर नॉर्थ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर नॉर्थ वेस्ट फर्स्ट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर नॉर्थ वेस्ट सेकेंड द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर साउथ एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर साउथ वेस्ट नाइन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर वेस्ट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफिसर सेंट्रल By order and in the name of the Lieutenant Governor of National Capital Territory of Delhi, P.C. Jain, Director. Copy of information. Copy for information. P.C. Jain, Director. Recruitment and qualification necessary for appointment. Recruitment and qualification necessary for appointment of the appointment to the post of welfare officer, probation officer, officer, prison welfare officer. Recruitment and qualifications necessary for appointment to the post of welfare officer, probation officer, prison welfare officers. Department of Women and Child Development notification, Delhi, the 14th March 2018, in exercise of the power conferred by the proviso to Article 309 of the Constitution, read with the Government of India Ministry of Home Affairs notification number. Dated 23rd July 1959, the Lieutenant Governor of National Capital Territory of Delhi is pleased to make the following amendment in the notification number F dated 12th January 2017 containing the rules regarding the मेथड ऑफ रिक्रूटमेंट एंड क्वालिफिकेशंस नेसेसरी फॉर अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ अपॉइंटमेंट टू द पोस्ट ऑफ वेलफेयर ऑफिसर प्रोबेशन ऑफिसर प्रिजनर वेलफेयर ऑफिसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ नेशनल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली नेमली सो टाइटल एंड कमेंसमेंट दीज रूल्स में बी कॉल्ड द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट डेवलपमेंट वेलफेयर ऑफिसर प्रिजनल वेलफेयर ऑफिसर पेंशन वेलफेयर ऑफिसर अमेंडमेंट रिक्रूटमेंट रूल 2018 They shall come into force with effect from the date of their publication in the official gazette. In the schedule annexed to the said notification for existing entry under column number 9 period of probation, if any, the following shall be substituted, namely, period of probation, if any, 2 years for Direct recruitment and promotion note. Successful mandatory induction training of at least 2 weeks for direct recruits as per provision in the field of duties and responsibility of the post from Union Territory Civil Services, National Institute of Public Corporation and Child Development by order and in the name of the LT Governor Delhi PC Jain Secretary Special Secretary Rakesh Shukla Member of the State Inspection Committee and District Inspection Committees. Members of the State Inspection Committees and District Inspection Committees. Department of Women and Child Development notification dated the 1st January 2018. F number in exercise of power conferred by the subsection 1 of section 54 read with subsection 59 of section 2 of the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015, 2 of 2016 and in compliance of sub-rule 2 and sub Rule 8 of Rule 41 of the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rule 2016, the Lieutenant Governor of the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi pleased to nominate the following member of the State Inspection Committee and District Inspection Committee, namely State Inspection Committee, the Director WCD, Member Secretary, State Child Protection Society Chairperson, the Chairperson, Member Child Welfare Committee, Juvenile Justice Board, Concerned Member, the Chairperson, Delhi Commission for Protection of Child Rights, Members, the Program Manager, State Adoption Resource Agency, Concerned member, the nominated member by the Principal Secretary, Department of Health and Family Welfare, Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi member. 6. The coordinator H.A. Huck Center for Child Rights member. Role of State Inspection Committees. As per Section 54, read with subsection 3 to subsection 7 of Rule 41 of Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children, Model Rule 2016, the State Inspection Committee shall mandatorily carry out inspection as under 1. Such inspection committee shall mandatorily conduct visits to all facility housing children in the area allocated at least once in the month in a terms of not less than three members, of whom at least one shall be a woman and one shall be a medical officer, and submit report of the finding of such visits within a week of their visit. That District Child Protection Unit, State Government, as the case may be, for further action. The State Inspection Committee shall carry out inspections of the child care institution as defined under subsection 21 of section 2 of the said Act, housing children in state in Form 46. The State Inspection Committee shall carry out random inspection of the institution housing children to determine where such institution is housing children in need of care and protection. 4. The State Inspection Committee shall submit report to Secretary of the Department implementing the Act. 5. The State Inspection Committee shall make recommendation for improving and development of the institutions in accordance with the provisions of the said Act and the rule made the rendered and shall forward the same to State Child Protection Society or the District Child Protection Unit for appropriate action. 6. The State Inspection Committee shall interact with the children during visit to the institution to determine their well-being and get their feedback. District Inspection Committees. West. The Member Child Welfare Committee, 1st Nirmal Chaya Complex. Member, the District Child Protection Officer, West. Member Secretary, the Chief Medical Officer, Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, Medical Care Unit, Nirmal Chaya Complex. Member, nominated member of civil society by District Child Protection Officer, DCPO. Member, Mental Health Expert, DDU Hospital, Government of National Capital Capital Territory of Delhi. Member, South, Northwest, Central and East, Northeast, Sadra, Outer and Rohini, Southwest, Najafgarh Division, Southeast, New Delhi and Railways, North. Role of District Inspection Committees. As per Sub-Rule 9 of Sub-Rule 13 of Rule 14 of Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rules 2016, the District Child Inspection Committee shall mandatorily carry out inspection as under. 1. The District Inspection Committee shall inspect all child care institutions in the district in Form 46. Two, The inspection of the facility housing children facilities housing children in the district shall be carried out at least once every 3 months. 3. The district inspection committee shall submit the report of the finding to the district child protection unit or the state government and shall also make suggestion for improvement and development of child care institutions in accordance with the provisions of the act and rules made thereunder. 4. The district inspection committee shall interact with the children during the visit to the institution, determine their well-being and to elicit their feedback. 5. The district child protection unit shall take necessary follow-up action on the report of the district inspection committee by order of the order and in the name of Lieutenant Governor of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, PC Jain, Special Secretary. Chairperson and member of Child Welfare Committee, Chairperson and member of Child Welfare Committee, 9. Department of Women and Child Development Notification, Delhi, 1st January 2018, F number exit. In exercise of the power conferred in exercise F number, in exercise of the power conferred by sub section 1, 2 and 6 of section 27, read with subsection 59 of section 2 of the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015-2016, the Lieutenant Governor of Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi is pleased to nominate the following person as chairperson and member of Child Welfare Committee 10. They shall exercise the power and discharge the duties conferred or assigned to such committee in relation to the children in need of care and protection under the said act in National Capital Territory of Delhi, namely Child Welfare Committee, name and address of phone number, chairperson and members. Poonam Malhotra, chairperson. Satyaveer Singh Mawai, member. The aforesaid chairperson and member of Child Welfare Committee 10 shall function from the designated premises for the period of 3 years from the date of notification. The Child Welfare Committee shall function in terms of the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015 and Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rule 2016 on all working days from 10 to 5 p.m. By order in the name of Lieutenant Governor of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, PC Jain, Special Secretary. Member of Delhi Commission for Protection of Child Rights. enhancement of the honorarium of Anganwadi workers, Anganwadi cum crèche workers and Anganwadi helpers. Department of Women and Child Development Notification, Delhi, in 7 July 2017, number F, Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi is pleased to enhance the honorarium of Anganwadi worker, Anganwadi cum crèche workers and Anganwadi helpers as under. Enhancement of honorarium of Anganwadi worker and Anganwadi cum crèche worker from 5,000 per month to 9,678 per month, of which Government of India share will remain the same, 1,800 per month. The Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi share will increase 300-200 per month to 7,878 per month. B. Enhancement of honorarium of Anganwadi helper from 2,500 per month to 4,839 per month, payable at 50% honorarium being paid to Anganwadi worker and Anganwadi cum crèche worker, of which Government of India share will remain the same, 900 per month. Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi share will increase from 1600 per month to 3939 per month. The enhancement will be effective from the date of notification by order of the national in the name of the Lieutenant Governor of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, PCGN, Special Secretary. Please to appoint members of DCPCR. Please to appoint the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rule 2016 notification by the Government of India. Please to nominate the name of chairperson and member of members in CWC. Lieutenant Governor Delhi is pleased to appoint Sri Rakesh Bhatnagar, D. Danix Officer, as Secretary DCPCR. Please to appoint members social worker for mentioned JJB. Please to appoint Sri Ramesh Negi, IAS, retired, as chairperson of the DCPCR. The Joint Director Counseling Recruitment Rule 2000. The Joint Director Counseling Recruitment Rule 2017. Delhi Pension Scheme to Women in Distress and City of Delhi in the age group of 18 years to Lifelong Amendment Rules 2017. Selection Committee under Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015 for the period of 3 years. Delhi Commission for Protection of Child Rights Amendment Rule 2017. Delhi Prisons Scheme to Women in Distress Amendment Rule 2016. Department of Social Welfare, WCD, Welfare Officer, Probation Officer, Prison Officer Recruitment Rule 2016. रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड रिसेटलमेंट एक्ट 2016, द ह्यूमन इम्यूनोडिफिशियंसी वायरस एंड एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनोडिफिशियंसी सिंड्रोम प्रिवेंशन एंड कंट्रोल एक्ट 2017, रिक्रूटमेंट रूल्स फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ डिप्टी सेक्रेटरी इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ लॉ जस्टिस एंड LAGNCTD, प्रोहिबिटर्स और रिस्ट्रिक्ट्स द प्लेइंग एंड आइडल पार्किंग ऑफ स्पेसिफाइड कैटेगरीज of vehicles on specified roads and areas, notification number, finance. Delhi Authority for Advance ruling with Dr. Abhishek Chandra Gupta, Additional Commissioner of Central Taxes, and Dr. Franklin ललतनी खुमा IAS स्पेशल कमिश्नर फर्स्ट मेंबर, अमेंडमेंट्स इन रूल 10 ऑफ दिल्ली रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ बर्थ एंड डेथ रूल 1999, नोटिफिकेशन स्टेट टैक्स. मुख्यमंत्री COVID-19 परिवार आर्थिक सहायता योजना, नोटिफिकेशन, इलेक्टेड मेंबर ऑफ डैम इलेक्शन 2021, मुख्यमंत्री COVID-19 परिवार आर्थिक सहायता योजना, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर नोटिफिकेशन दिल्ली इन 2 June 2021, F41, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड इमीडिएट फाइनेंशियल रिलीफ इन केस ऑफ डेथ ऑफ फैमिली मेंबर्स ड्यू टू COVID-19 एंड कंटिन्यूड फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस टू फैमिलीज अफेक्टेड बाय द डेथ ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर नोटिफिकेशन दिल्ली 2 June 2021, F, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड फाइनेंशियल रिलीफ in case of death of family members due to COVID-19 and continued financial assistance to families affected by the death of the breadwinner due to COVID-19 pandemic, the Lieutenant Governor and City of Delhi is pleased to notify the Mukhya Mantri COVID-19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana 1. So title, extent and commencement. A. The scheme may be called as Mukhya Mantri COVID-19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana. B. The scheme shall be applicable for the NCT of Delhi. C. The scheme shall come into force with effect from the date of its publication in the Delhi Gazette. टू ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द स्कीम्स. द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द स्कीम्स आर ए टू प्रोवाइड फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंट टू द सर्वाइविंग फैमिली ऑफ द ब्रेड अर्नर हु हैज डाइड ड्यू टू कोविड 19 पैंडेमिक इन दिल्ली सिंस द आउटब्रेक ऑफ द डिजीज. गवर्नमेंट विल ऑल्सो कंसिडर अ सिंगल मेंबर ऑफ द affected family to be enrolled as a civil defense volunteer. Beside these, the state affirms to look after the health and education need of the dependent children as per existing policy. B, to give in extra gratia a payment of rest 50,000 per for each death to the family of deceased. The ex gratia assistance shall be given to the kith and kin of the person deceased due to COVID-19 after the he applies in the format prescribed by the Revenue Department GNCTD. 3. The components corresponding quantum of financial assistance and eligibility are detailed below. A. Component A. Monthly financial assistance to the family of the deceased. Eligibility and quantum of assistance. Situation: death of working member of the family due to COVID-19. Husband, wife, eligible dependent amount. Remarks: husband, wife, raise 2,500 for life. Wife can get widow pension also in addition if eligible. Wife, husband raise 2,500 for life nil. Single parent, other parent already died either due to COVID or otherwise separated. Divorced. Each child below 25 years of age raise 2,500 to each child of the deceased parents till they attain age of 25 years. Each child below 25 years of age would be considered for financial assistance in these cases if one a parent died of COVID and other died in earlier years. Both husband and wife died where alternate one of them died due to COVID. Each child below age of 25 years, father or mother in case of one children, raised 2,500 to each child till the age of 25 years. In case of father or mother for life, only one will get the assistance. Father and mother can avail old age pension in addition to this if eligible. Unmarried working son, daughter, father or mother raise 2,500 for life. Father and mother can avail old age pension in addition to this if eligible. Brother and sister department, brother, sister, if they are physically or intellectually challenged, raise 2,500 for life. Physically or intellectually challenged siblings staying with the breadwinner and dependent on him. In case husband and wife of the deceased a bread earner is getting the benefit of the scheme, then the sibling in the special needs category, as cited in last column, shall not be eligible. If family is survived by only minor children, then applicant beneficiary will be the foster parent guardian who has been declared fit under the provision of JJ Act by the Child Welfare Committee. The financial assistant shall be transferred to the joint bank account in the name of the minor child and the foster parent guardian. The deceased and dependents both shall be residents of Delhi. Death must be due to COVID related, example certified as COVID death as per MHA data, or death with 1 month of testing COVID positive and verified by health department as COVID death. Methodology and procedure. Documents required. The following documents shall be attached with the application. 1. Proof of residence of both deceased and dependents. 2. Death certificate. 3. Proof of COVID death. 4. Documents establishing relationship between deceased and applicant. 5. Bank account details of the applicant. 6. In case of disabled dependent siblings, disability certificate. 7. Proof of age of the dependent children. 8. Other as required in e-district portal. Procedure 1. Health department shall share list database of COVID death with Department of Social Welfare, which in turn shall send that to the area SDMs through DCHQ Revenue Department for verification of cases falling in their respective jurisdiction. 2. SDM will use a pool of 100 officials of Delhi government as created by the respective SDM to act as representative of subdivision level for conducting of home visit. SDM shall digitally assign government representative for home visit who shall go for verification at the address provided by the applicant and also provide assistance for submission of details in the application. 3. The Delhi government representative at the time of home visit will collect all relevant details and fill it for the dependent in digital form using their tablet, mobile phone. They shall conduct the home visit with 3 objectives. A. Verify, clarify the death mentioned in the application form. B. Recommend the preparation of the documents like death certificate, hospital report, etc. to their SDM in genuine cases if the same is missing. C. Note the details of children below 25 years to determine the quantum of financial assistance. 4. Based on verification application and home visit, SDM to send his recommendation within 5 working days of submission of report by the field staff. The recommendation shall be sent online through e-district portal to district social welfare officer of Department of Social Welfare. Welfare of section sanction. Welfare for sanction SDM to recommend or reject the case in a period of total 12 days from the date of application. 5. The district social welfare officer or south social welfare department shall scrutinize the document submitted as per eligibility criteria and shall approve the request and process it for release of payment to the social welfare HQ within 3 days of receive of the recommendations for the SDM. The financial assistance requisite should be accepted or rejected with reasons recorded within a maximum time limit of 15 days of the application, and the financial assistance should start from the month in which application was submitted. Appellate mechanism. In case of rejection of the application, the SDM would forward the rejected cases with reasons to DM online and SMS message to the applicants, given details of the office and address for appeal. Such applicants, those whose application is rejected can appeal to the district magistrate for reconsideration. The DM shall dispose of the appeal based on SOP developed by SWD. B. Component B. One-time ex gratia payment to the families of deceased. 1. Eligibility of quantum of assistance. In case of death of any patient who is COVID positive, either in institutional setting or at home, an amount of rest 50,000 would be given in ex gratia to the family of the deceased. This would be irrespective of whether the deceased was the bread earner of the family. The ex gratia amount would cover all death that has taken place due to COVID-19 pandemic. The ex gratia amount of Rs. 50,000 would be given per death. Methodology. The components of the scheme shall be operated by the revenue department, and the details procedure for implementation is recommended by the revenue department as under. 3. Methodology and procurement. Documents required. The following documents shall be attached with the application to be filed by the applicants in concerned district. 1. Proof of residence of both disease or dependents. 2. Death certificate. 3. Proof of COVID death. 4. Documents establish relationship between deceased and applicants. 5. Bank account details of the applicants. Procedure. The revenue department is already running a scheme approved by cabinet cabinet decision number 2028-10 dated 5 March 2020 and circulated wide order number F-187 relief building collapse dated 5 March 2020 granting ex gratia relief in revenue eventualities. The disbursement procedure adopted in this scheme may also be followed for the schemes under consideration. Head of account for payment. The disbursement may be made from major head 2247 relief for which all the powers to sanction of relief to the victim have already been delegated to all the deputy commissioners being HOD in all cases in accordance with a scale अप्रूव्ड कंपोनेंट अथॉरिटी द कंपोनेंट अथॉरिटी टू ग्रांट द एक्स ग्रेशिया ऑफ 5000 टू द फैमिलीज ऑफ डिजीज डाइड ऑफ कोविड 19 शैल बी कंसर्न डीएम एज ऑलरेडी बीइंग डन अंडर द ऑलरेडी रनिंग स्कीम्स स्टेटेड अबव appellate authority. In case of rejection of application by concerned DM, the appeal can file the grievance before the divisional commissioner. Death must be due to COVID related. Example, certified as COVID death, as HMA death, or death within 1 month of a test COVID positive and verified by health department as COVID death by order in name of the Lieutenant Governor of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, Dr. Rashmi Singh, Special Secretary, Director of Social Welfare. Uploaded by the date of printing at Government of India Press, Ring Road, Mayapuri, New Delhi, 64 and published by Controller of Publication Delhi 54 Alok Kumar. Notification of elected member of DM election 2021. Notification number cell tax. Notification number state tax. Notification state tax. Social welfare rehabilitation services. Mukhyamantri COVID 19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana. Directorate of Agricultural Marketing notification of elected member of DEM election 2020 transport vehicular movement on main Chandni Chowk road from Red Fort to Fatehpuri Mosque. District Administration Revenue RR scheme and summary finance notification state tax. Transport vehicular movement on main Chandni Chowk road from Red Fort to Fatehpur Mosque. Directorate of Agricultural Marketing notification under Rules 23.1 regarding schedule of election of elect the member of new marketing committee finance notification. Directorate of Agricultural Marketing Finance लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग नोटिफिकेशन रिगार्डिंग अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ एडवोकेट्स एज गवर्नमेंट प्लीडर काउंसिल्स. To be published in part 2 of the Delhi Gazette, Extraordinary Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, Land and Building Department, B Block, Vikas Bhavan, IP State, New Delhi, Notification Number F1, in superseding of all notifications issued earlier in this regard, the Lieutenant Governor of National Capital Territory of Delhi hereby appoint the following advocates as government pleader councils, pleaders, government pleaders councils, government pleaders councils within the meaning of subsection 7 of section 2 of the Code of Civil Procedure 1908. For the High Court of Delhi at New Delhi and District Courts at Delhi in relation to an suit appeal CWP, CCP, RFAs and LPAs and other proceedings by against the government of NCT Delhi and or the Union Territory of Delhi in relation to suit. In relation to suit, appeal, CWP, CCP, RFAs and LPAs and other proceedings. In relation to suit, appeal, CWP, CCP, RFAs, LPAs and other proceedings. In relation to suit, appeal, CWP, CCP, RFAs and LPAs and other proceeding by the by or against the government of NCT of Delhi and or Union of India in relation to the affairs in the land and building department, government of NCT of Delhi, land acquisition collector and or public officers whose defense has been undertaken by it for period of 2 years from 13th March 2021 to 12th March 2023 for the High Court. For District Courts. For miscellaneous or execution cases in District Courts. The appointment is terminable on 1 month notice on either side. The appointment is subject to the terms and condition as the appointment is term on 1 month notice on either side. The appointment is subjected to the terms and condition as contained in the notification dated for the High Court and dated for the district and subordinate court issued by the Department of Law, Justice and Legislative Affairs, Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, and also as may be prescribed from time to time by order in the name of Lieutenant Governor of National Capital Territory of Delhi. Ajay Kumar Gupta, Special Secretary, LNB. Copy of for information and necessary action. Copy for information and necessary action. Ajay Kumar Gupta, Special Secretary, LNB. नोटिफिकेशन डेटेड मुख्यमंत्री घर घर राशन योजना फूड एंड सप्लाई। डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड सप्लाई एंड कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स नोटिफिकेशन दिल्ली ऑन 20 फरवरी 2021 FNF इन एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द पावर कॉन्फर्ड बाय सेक्शन 12 रेड विथ सेक्शन 24 ऑफ नेशनल फूड सिक्योरिटी एक्ट 2013 नंबर 20 ऑफ 2013 द स्कीम डॉक्यूमेंट ऑफ ड्रॉप स्टेप delivery of ration wheat flour rice and sugar under targeted public distribution system under mukhyamantri ghar ghar ration yojana is notified mukhyamantri ghar ghar ration yojana one background the national food security act 2013 NFSA 2013 provides for food and nutrition security by ensuring access to adequate quantity of quality food at affordable price to people to live a life with dignity. NFSA 2013 Inter alia provides for coverage of up to 75% of rural population and up to 50% of the urban population at all India level under TPDS. As per NFSA 2013, public distribution system is operated under the joint responsibility of the central and the state governments. The central government through Food Corporation of India, FCI, has the responsibility for procurement, storage, transportation and bulk allocation of food grains to the state governments. The operational responsibility include allocation within state, identification of eligible household, ensuring actual delivery or supply of the food grains to the entitled persons at the specified price rate with the state government. The priority households PHH in Delhi are presently entitled to receive food grain at 5 kg per person per month, 4 kg of wheat and 1 kg of rice at the issues price of rice 300 per kg and rice 200 per 2 rupees per kg for wheat respectively. The Antyodaya Anna Yojana AAY household receive 35 kg for food grains per household per month at the same subsidized price. They also get 1 kg sugar per household per month of rice 13.5 per kg additionally. In order to manage the supply chain operation which involves lifting of commodities from FCI's godowns to the fair price shops, the department avail the service of Delhi State Civil Supplies Corporation Limited DSCSC, which is the wholly government owned organization associated with the Food and Civil Supplies Department GNCTD DSCSC. is responsible for transportation of wheat and rice from 6 FCI Food Corporation of India godowns and sugar from 2 state-owned godowns to Fair Price Shops FPS spread across Delhi. The distribution of commodities to TPTS beneficiaries in Delhi is currently managed by network of more than 2,000 licensed Fair Price Shops appointed by the department in line with the guidelines of Targeted Public Distribution System TPDS to home delivery of ration under Targeted Public Distribution System with an aim to reform the Targeted Public Distribution System PDS in Delhi and to ensure that targeted beneficiaries receive their monthly ration in transparent manner with maximum ease. The government of NCT of Delhi has planned to roll out a new scheme, Mukhya Mantri Ghar Ghar Ration Yojana, also framed to as MMGGRY wide cabinet decision number 2561 dated 6 March 2018. 2857 dated 21-7-2020 and 2878 dated 9 October 2020. The new scheme is designed to ensure that the entitled quantity of quality food at affordable price is being distributed at the doorstep of genuine beneficiary. The scheme involves distribution of packaged wheat flour atta WFA instead of wheat. Also, the rice will also be cleaned and packed before distribution to the beneficiary. 3. Framework for doorstep delivery ration. As per new scheme, example, Mukhya Mantri Ghar Ghar Yojana food grants will be lifted from FCI godown by millers, millers, impaneled by DSCSC through tendering process and transported to the milling units, where wheat will be converted into wheat flour, chakki atta, WFA, and packed in packets of different wheats as per requirement. Similarly, rice will be lifted from FCI godown to rice processing unit, where it will be cleaned and packed in packets of different weight as per requirement. These packets items will be delivered to designated FPS by millers, which will be further delivered to the doorstep of beneficiary. Distribution of packaged item, wheat, flour, atta and rice will be done only after successful biometric authentication using EPOS devices. The cost of subsidized food grain and a specified amount as milling conversion charges will be collected from the beneficiaries. The scheme will be optional, and an optional shall be taken from the beneficiaries of existing TPDS scheme in Delhi as to whether they want to enroll under MMGGRY or continue under existing TPDS. Those who are not opting for MMGGRY shall continue to get their ration as per existing mechanism and price. Beneficiary will be able to exercise option in the beginning of every financial year. implementation of the MMGGRY scheme will be done in two stages. One, stage one, Delhi State Civil Supplies Corporation Limited, DSCSC, has been engaged as the implementation and monitoring agency for stage one and stage one, Delhi State Civil Supply Corporation Limited, DSCSC, has been engaged in the implementation and monitoring agency for stage one and is entitled with the implementation of Miller's processing units who shall carry out the lifting food grains, wheat and rice from FCI godowns, transporting to their dedicated milling units where it would be milled, processed, packed and then transported to the designated fair price shops for doorstep delivery of ration to the end beneficiaries. The DSCSC Limited will empanel millers who shall step up and operate milling and milling and processing unit for MMGGRY scheme. The miller will be responsible for lifting and transportation of commodities, wheats and rice from FCI godown to these dedicated milling and processing unit. The miller and processing unit shall store, clean and grind the wheat using only the stone chakki mills to make wheat flour atta. Similarly, the rice shall be cleaned of all impurities like straws, jute bag, thread, dust, etc. The wheat flour, atta and clean rice shall be packed using standard quality of packaging materials and shall have the name of mill, batch number, date and manufacturing expiry batch before date and all mandatory information on each packet. The packet commodity shall be then delivered at the fair price shop DDCCWS for further distribution to the doorstep for the end beneficiaries. Stage 2, Delhi Consumers Cooperative Wholesale Store Limited, DCCWS, has been engaged with the responsibility of setting up a fair price shop across various districts of Delhi. Further, it shall impanel direct to home delivery DHD agency for delivering the packet commodities to the doorstep of the end beneficiaries from DCCWS Associated Fair Price Shop. The DCCWS shall impanel direct to home delivery agency who will responsible for lifting the package ration from fair price shop and deliver the same to doorstep of the beneficiaries. The DHD agency shall notify the beneficiaries in advance through SMS. The package ration shall be handed over to beneficiary only after his or successful biometric authentication using the ePOS device and EPOD proof of delivery shall be captured for records. The ration card holders may draw their full entitlements of food grain packaged ration in more than one installment. There will be provision of a grievance management system to enable the beneficiary MMGGRY to raise their grievance related to the scheme. A call center for beneficiary is also envisaged under the scheme. The DHD agency shall also carry out beneficiary reach out programs from time to time to provide various schemes related information to the beneficiaries. To ensure transparency and to prevent leakage, diversion, substitution, theft, etc., the scheme shall be monitored and closed by the department. The entire operation from lifting of food grain from FCI, mailing, packaging till the delivery of packaged commodities to the beneficiary shall be carried out under CCTV monitoring, and the transportation of commodities shall be done in GPS fitted vehicles. This issues with the prior approval of Honorable Minister Food Supplies and Consumer Affairs based on a cabinet decision number 2561 dated 6 March 2018, cabinet decision number 2857 dated 21 July 2020, and cabinet decisions number 2878 dated 19 October 2020. Rajesh Ahuja, Assistant Commissioner. Notification, cell tax notification. Of Constitution of State Advisory Board on Disability under Section 66 of RPWD Act 2016 in the National Capital Territory of Delhi. They are noting sheet on one side of a file and other documents like letter, schemes, inspection reports, all on the other side. Note sheet is indicating N1, N2, and copy attached on other side is being written as C1, C2. So there are note or noting sheet, note, letter, orders, circulars, important schemes, acts, rules, constitution. So you need to learn about noting sheet, letter, issuing letter, preparing a noting sheet, issuing letter, passing orders, different schemes, acts, rule, constitutions. So here first of all we will watch circulars. Circular, check the circular number for complete details. Social Welfare Rehabilitation Service Office Circular. Circular for Bhaiya Dooj Festival 2021. Government of NCT, Delhi Department of Social Welfare, GNLX Complex, Delhi Gate, New Delhi 2, Administrative Branch. Circular. Subject, the circular to circulate the notification issued by MSJE to all the homes, institutions of the Department of Social Welfare, sir. Please find enclosed here with the notification number 3816 20 DD3 dated 4 January 2021 issued by MSJE. Wide which specified guidelines has been issued in RO persons with disability by the concerned ministry, example Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, with the request to upload on website of the Department of Information and necessary actions for all section officer admin to Gazetted Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Department of Empowerment, Press and Disabilities, Divyangjan notification. This is again notification. Circular for Bhaiya Dooj Festival 2021 regarding application for preparation of panel of Audiers regarding invitation for participation in the inter-school aquatic meet 2021-22 sports branch SRAO FNS circular number regarding OM endorsed to Chief Executive Officer DJB regarding change of PCP 1 and PCP 2 central and particular Vidyalay regarding vacancies of teachers and staff of Department of Education. Regarding vacancies of teachers and staff, Directorate of Education. Scrutiny of documents for the post of कंडक्टर हैज बीन पोस्टपोन फ्रॉम 1 नवंबर 2021 टू 3 नवंबर 2021. ट्रेनिंग एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन इनवाइटिंग एप्लीकेशन फॉर अलॉटमेंट ऑफ टाइप 1 एंड टाइप 4 गवर्नमेंट अकोमोडेशन अंडर DTTE पूल इन ऑफलाइन मोड. सर्कुलर नंबर, सर्कुलर डेट, डिपार्टमेंट, सर्कुलर सब्जेक्ट. अ रिवीजन ऑफ रेट ऑफ डियरनेस अलाउंसेस DA टू सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय ड्यू फ्रॉम 1 July 2021 to calculation of monthly contribution towards cost of pension payable during foreign service regarding 3 global tender inquiry GTE under rule 161(4) of the general financial rules GFR 2017 regarding admission notice for RIMC Dehradun for the term July 2022, examination cell ACG1 circular number dated organization of pre Nehru hockey tournament for junior boys youth under 17 years and sub juniors boys under 15 years category for the year 2021 sport branch organization of zonal sports competition 2021 sports branch organization of zonal sports competition 2021-22 sports branch instruction on non compliance of DDMA dated 8 October 2021 in respect of non-vaccinated officers, official, permanent contractual, ad hoc, and outsourced. Instruction on non-compliance of DDMA order dated 8-10-2021 in respect of non-vaccinated officers, official, permanent, contractual, ad hoc and outsourced. Sir, Madam, this department is in the receipt of some reference seeking clarification regarding action requiring to be against the officials who are not complying with the directions of DDMA as COVID wide aforesaid order dated 8 October 2021 by attending office after 15 October 2021 despite non-administration of even the first dose of vaccination. It may be certified that all concerned that the non-compliance of order DDMA shall attract penal action as provided under section 51-60 of the Disaster Management Act 2005 as per section 21B of DDMA Act 2005. Whoever without रीजनेबल कॉज रिफ्यूज टू कंप्लाई विद एनी डिसीजन गिवन बाय और ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और द नेशनल एग्जीक्यूटिव कमेटी और द स्टेट एग्जीक्यूटिव कमेटी ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट अथॉरिटी अंडर दिस एक्ट सेल ऑन वैक्सीन be punishable with imprisonment for a term which may be extended to 1 year or with fine or with both, and if such obstruction or refusal to comply with the directions result in loss of lives of inmates, imminent danger thereof shall be co-vaccines be punishable with imprisonment for term which may be extended to 2 years. According all registrar, principal, controller, BTE and branch in charge DTE, HQ are hereby requested to take appropriate action and forward status report within 3 days in RO and officials who have not yet been administered even a single dose of vaccine. This issue with prior approval of Directorate DTE, your faithfully. Anurag, Deputy Director Admin, dated the PPS Secretary TTE, Director TTE, the same system analysis TTE HQ, the request to upload the above communication on Department website. Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, Directorate of Training and Technical Education, introduction of IMS-GEMM, integration of smooth and hassle-free procurement of goods through GEM portal, BV, all the Department of Government of NCT of Delhi. ACG circular number dated, submitted for certificate of vaccination. Government of NCT of Delhi, Directorate of Audit. In compliance of order issued from DDMA GNCT of Delhi, wide dated 8 October 2021, shall all the official staff of Directorate of Audit, audit parties is hereby directed to submit certificate of vaccination at least first dose administered immediately to the DDO HQ. Circulars now will read orders. Shopping Mall Community Center of Block Shalimar Bagh. Office order number regarding providing laptop facility to AFE, AE and JE of DJB. Transfer posting of Assistant Commissioner Inspector. Regarding additional work of L1 branch. Regarding transfer posting of Das Section Officer, Social Welfare Rehabilitation Service. Order in RO of Naveen Singh SRAO, Delhi Fire Service, Govind Banquet Hall 512B, Jheel, Khuranja, Gita Colony Chowk, H Block, Safdarjung Hospital Complex, Ring Road. Registrar Cooperative Society information regarding registration of Awadh Jan Kalyan Cooperative Urban Thrift and Credit Society Limited. The others Sahu Registrar Cooperative Society. Official Social Welfare Rehabilitation Services Office Order. Department of Social Welfare Order. All Office of Department of Social Welfare related to Special Secretary cum Director SW Cell routed through joint director SW with immediate effect. The issues with the approval of special secretary come director SW directorate deputy director admin dated. Social Welfare Rehabilitation Service Transfer Posting Order. Order. The transfer posting in RO the following official is hereby ordered with immediate effect as under. Sri aforesaid officials are hereby also stand relieved from their present place of posting with the direction to join new assignment forthwith without waiting for any formal relieving from their present place of posting. Non-compliance will be viewed seriously. These issue with prior approval of the competent authority SW section officer admin 2. Department of Women and Child Development, transfer of junior assistant grade 4 Das, 2 November 2021. The transfer posting of the following staff of the department is hereby made with immediate effect as under. The above mentioned officials are hereby stand relieved from their present place of posting with the direction to report to their new place of posting without waiting for any formal relieving order. Further, the salary posting in respect of the above mentioned officials shall remain unchanged. This issue with prior approval of the director WCD, joint deputy admin. Regarding transfer posting of the following staff of the department is hereby made with immediate effect. Regarding transfer posting of the following staff of the department is hereby made with immediate effect. Department Food and Safety, VVIP, duty of the month of November 2021. Transfer posting taken on strength order of pay purpose only in RO SS Satyam Chauhan, stenographer grade 3. Training of technical education, modification in order regarding transfer for salary purpose only in RO SHBK Bajpal, senior assistant, Delhi Fire Service, World Class Skill Center, ITI, Dhirpur. Delhi Fire Service, education, reallocation of school to relieved guest teacher of PGT Physics EV branch. Education, memorandum office offer of appointment to the post of TGT Sanskrit female under the post grade 145-17-1 memorandum E13 Manch DR. दिल्ली जल बोर्ड, दिल्ली जल बोर्ड। सोशल वेलफेयर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर ऑर्डर, द साइकाइट्रिक्स क्लिनिकल साइकोलॉजिस्ट सीपी, साइकाइट्रिक सोशल वर्कर PSW, ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपिस्ट OT, द फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट PT, वर्किंग इन डिपार्टमेंट इज हियर बाय असाइन ड्यूटीज इन रोटेशन फॉर वेरियस होम इंस्टीट्यूशन एज पर Annex 1 विथ इमीडिएट इफेक्ट। द अबव सेड रोस्टर शुड बी कंपाइल्ड स्ट्रिक्टली दिस इश्यू विथ अप्रूवल ऑफ स्पेशल सेक्रेटरी कम डायरेक्टर्स SW। रिगार्डिंग सर्कुलर, प्लीज फाइंड एनक्लोज हेयर विथ लेटर नंबर डेटेड इश्यू बाय सेक्रेटरी WCD वाइड विच ऑफ हैज बीन डायरेक्टेड टू स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलो द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द ऑर्डर 28 अप्रैल 2021। द मैटर स्पेसिफाइड अंडर रूल 23 ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन ऑफ बिजनेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ नेशनल कैपिटल ट्रेटरी रूल्स। इन एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द पावर कॉन्फर्ड बाय प्रोविजंस टू सब सेक्शन 2 ऑफ सेक्शन 44 ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली एक्ट 1991 एज अमेंडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली अमेंडमेंट एक्ट 2021, द लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर ऑफ नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली हियर बाय स्पेसिफाइड द फॉलोइंग मैटर्स ऑफ ऑब्टेनिंग ओपिनियन ऑफ लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग क्लोज 4 ऑफ आर्टिकल 239 AA of the Constitution before making any action in pursuance of the decisions of the council minister or a minister of empower of government, state government, appoint appropriate government, lieutenant governor, administration or chief कमिश्नर एज द केस मे बी अंडर द लॉ ऑफिस ऑफ द कैपिटल टेरिटरी। 1. द मैटर फॉलिंग अंडर द लॉ अंडर द पार्लियामेंट और एक्सटेंडेड टू नेशनल कैपिटल टेरिटरी ऑफ दिल्ली बाय सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एनी मैटर enumerated in the state listed concurrent lists following fall, the matter having subjected while the lieutenant governor is to act decision according with section 41 of the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi 1991 public police public officer land service etc be making subordinate legislations rules regulations legislation rules regulations schemes bylaws etc establishing or constitution reconstitution of statutory bodies such as authority board committee commission matters relating to recommendation of Delhi Finance Commission constitution under Delhi Finance Commission 19 grant parole under act 20 as rules made there under circular this reference to direction of worthy chief secretary Delhi communicated wide letter dated citing order dated April where the principal secretary honorable lieutenant governor Delhi has specified the matter of obtaining opinion of the honorable lieutenant governor in terms of provisions to clause 4 of article 239 AA of the Constitution. However, it is found that the relevant and specific provisions mentioned in paragraph 1, 2 or 3 of the order dated 24-2021 is not mentioned by the department while seeking approval of the Honorable Lieutenant Governor. In view of the above, it is directed that the very provisions of order dated 28 April 2021 of the Honorable Lieutenant Governor Secretariat be strictly followed and the files be submitted for obtaining the opinion approval of Honorable Lieutenant Governor only after clearly indicating the specific provision of the said order under which the file matter is being submitted. Madhu Vyas Secretary WCD IF Circular, please find enclosed here with number PP dated 6 October issued by Secretary WCD White which it has been directed to strictly follow the provisions of order dated 28 April 2021 of the Honorable Lieutenant Governor's Secretariat and mention the relevant and specific provisions mentioned in paragraph 1, 2, 3 of the order dated 28 April 2021 while sending any proposal for obtaining the opinion of Honorable Lieutenant Governor Delhi. In this regard, all the district officer superintendent of home institution branch in charge of DWCD headquarters are required to go through the above mentioned order and comply with the directions. Public Department of Women and Child Development public notice on draft recruitment rules for the post of caretaker in Department of WCD regarding timely disbursement of wages of outsourced employees regarding due to demise of Srimati Pormila Pion on 26 September, her services was ceased on 26 September इम्पोर्टेंट स्कीम्स। क्लिक द इम्पोर्टेंट स्कीम लिंक फॉर कंप्लीट डिटेल्स। होटल महाजन प्लेस 10830 झंडे वालान रोड चौक मोतिया खान। इंटरनेशनल यूथ होटल नंबर 5 नयाय मार्ग चाणक्यपुरी। टोटो इंटरनेशनल गेस्ट हाउस टूटी चौक पहाड़गंज। वीनस इंटरनेशनल गली नंबर 10 ई गजेट। दिस इज ई गजेट। नोटिफिकेशन ट्रांसपोर्ट डिपार्टमेंट नोटिफिकेशन वी हैव गॉन थ्रू डिफरेंट ई गैजेट। Now you know about note sheet, official letters, circulars, orders, important schemes, rules, regulations, act, rules, constitutions, etc. Thank you very much for watching this video.